Hello and welcome to our 5th financial accounting class. Dear student, last time we have defined the difference between cash accounting and accrual accounting and the difference between capital expenses and revenue expenses, and we also defined the difference between cash in hand and profit. In our today's class, I am going to discuss the most important concept of financial accounting, that is debit and credit. This concept is very important in the financial accounting. And at this stage, if we learn the debit and credit, this will help out in the series of next upcoming lectures, and also to learn the financial accounting in future. In our today's class, we also discuss the single entry bookkeeping and also the difference between single entry bookkeeping and double entry bookkeeping. In the last, we have also discussed the dual aspect of transaction. Dear student, if we learn debit and credit today, this will help out our whole learning with the subject of financial accounting, and we unable to learn these concepts, then it is difficult for us to learn the financial accounting further. Now, formally, I have started our today's class with an quotation written by a famous geologist, Sir Charles. Charles said, "Never call an accountant a credit to his profession. A good accountant is debited to his profession." This Charles quotation tells us the importance of debit and credit. With this quotation, I have started our today's class, and the first topic that we have discussed today is debit and credit. The word debit and credit are derived from two Latin words, debitum and creditum. Debitum means something in due, and creditum means something in trust to another. In simple words, the word debit means receiving benefit. On the other hand, the word credit means providing benefit. We can say the word debit is the left hand side, and we also said the credit means the right hand side. We can remember these two terms by remembering the words in and out. It means when we are saying in, this means something is coming to us. On the other hand, if we talk about the words out, it means that something is going from us to another one. Let's take an example of debit and credit. The first example is Mr. John purchased a mobile of $100. In this example, mobile is coming to us. It means it will be debited. And the cash is going from us. It means this is credit. In the second example, Mr. Charlie purchased a land of $20,000. In this example, land is coming. This will be debited. And cash is going from us. This means this is credit. In the third example, Mr. Raza holds goods of $500. It means in this example, the cash is coming to us because we are selling some goods of $500, and goods going from us, this will be credited. In the last example, Mr. Mohsin paying salaries of $500. In this example, $500 is going from us. This will be credited, and salaries increases. This will be debited. From these examples, we can easily identify and differentiate between debit and credit. In our today's topic, the next topic is single entry bookkeeping and double entry bookkeeping. The accounting system that records only one aspect of transaction in books of account is called single entry bookkeeping. In single entry bookkeeping, we are only entering debit or credit, means to say that only one aspect of transaction is recorded. We recorded only debited side of transaction or the credit side of transaction. On the other hand, if we talk about the double entry bookkeeping system, the double entry bookkeeping system means that we record both aspects of transaction is recorded in the books of accounting. Both aspects of transactions mean we are recorded not only one aspect of transaction, but we also recorded both aspect, means to say that we are recording debited and credited transaction in it. So that is the difference between single entry bookkeeping and double entry bookkeeping. Single entry bookkeeping, we are recording only one aspect of transaction. Contrary to this, in the double entry bookkeeping, we are recording both aspect of transactions, means to say debit and credit. The last point for today's class is dual aspect of transaction. In accounting, every debited is equal to every credited. For every debited, there is an equal to every credit. This is also known as dual aspect of transaction. That is, every transaction has two aspects, debit and credit, and they are always equal. It means every debited is equal to every credited. We can also explain it with the help of an example. Mr. John purchased a mobile of $100. It means we are creating two accounts, one account mobile and other account is cash. Mobile account has $100 and cash account has also $100. It means the debit balance of mobile phone $100 is equal to credit balance of cash account $100. Both debit and credit are equal. That is the dual aspect of transaction. This discussion of financial accounting is not over there. We are meet in the next financial accounting class with the new concept. Thank you very much. Take care.